Hello everyone, my name is Stephen Constant and my controversy is technology integration, computer technology changing the pedagogy of academia in the 21st century. All right, well, some of the topics that we'll be covering are the challenges of integration, understanding technology literacy, gender inclusiveness in educational technology, engaging young boys in learning, e-learning tools improving Hispanic students' academic performance, learning in a mobile age, an investigation of student motivation, and young people, new technologies, and learning at home. Challenges of integration, understanding technology literacy. State legislation mandated that all public schools in the state of Pennsylvania integrate technology into the classroom curriculum. Reform was passed in 2002, part of the No Child Left Behind Act. With that, there were grants passed and studies created to understand long-term and short-term effects of the change in curriculum. Studies also showed that lack of teacher literacy of technology caused limitations in the classroom instruction. Generational gaps in attitude towards integration between service teachers, which are also known as student teachers, and in-service teachers, practicing teachers, occurred. Older teachers were more antagonistic toward the change routine. Now, the education technologists came in to aid and give trainings and extra support to teachers. When the educators have a clear understanding and proper training of new technologies, learning grew and learning was achieved. Being an integration technologist, I can relate fully to this. For the simple fact that in the beginning of the year, the teachers didn't want, they thought they knew everything, and they didn't really want to integrate any technology or learn anything new and wanted to keep everything the same. But after realizing that PARC was going to be rolled out this year and that kids are gonna need to know how to understand computer-based testing, my job became more valuable. E-tools, improving Hispanic students' academic performance. Researchers reviewed the impact that technology had on Hispanic higher ed students from South Texas. And it turns out that the Hispanic population is the fastest growing segment in the U.S. population. And it is estimated by 2050 that the Hispanic population will represent one third of the U.S. population. Web 2.0 technologies have made an impact in social as well as academic constructs. More students are looking toward distance education curriculum formats to earn their degrees. We were talking about gender equality before. It goes back, now it goes to ESL second language learners. They need the same equality as well, and they need those tools. All right, so the next topic that we're going to be discussing is about gender inclusiveness in educational technology. Research is focused on inclusiveness of educational tools on boys and girls. Developer-based or designed gender scripts embedded in e-tools affected the learning. Since most of the developers and software designers were males, they wrote scripts that favored boys. And what the research has shown is that more inclusive scripts create greater positive attitudes towards learning for everybody. Using imagery and audio features make e-tools more attractive to boys and girls. It also turns out that teachers influence the way that the students use the e-tools. Research also shows that girls work at a higher quality when tools are inclusive. The point of this controversy really is about creating a nice balance. And I know that outside of the virtual world, it's very hard for equality in the classroom. Just for the simple fact that if you have a male teacher, the teacher is going to have their biases. If you have a female teacher, those teachers are going to have their biases. It's a very tricky line to create something that is balanced for all genders. Which leads to our next topic, which is engaging young boys in learning. This study comes from Canada. Achievement gap between boys and girls is increasing, and the traditional class structure does not favor boys' aggressive natural nature. Research aimed at engaging students in strong writing process and to build confidence. So they use computer programs like Microsoft Office and computer games to engage the boys. Their research focused on boys with diverse learning issues and behavioral problems, also ADHD. The technology helped in stabilizing physical and mental behavioral issues. And it turns out that researchers believe that schools must consider changing class structure to be more gender inclusive. This is great for the simple fact that it goes back to the controversy that we had before. There needs to be a balance, and the students that have a problem, they need to be recognized, and the teachers need to come up with, and it, well, it's not even the teachers, it's really the schools. School systems have to figure out alternative ways of engaging students, not just boys, but girls too, second language learners as well. They can't be left by the wayside. Learning in a mobile age, investigation of student motivation. The 21st century has created new waves of technology. Teachers are using tablets and smartphones in classrooms to stimulate student attention. Research shows motivational positives of using mobile devices for learning is great. Malone and Leppard's taxonomy of intrinsic motivations, making games both fun and educational, has really come to impact the learning structures in classrooms. And students showed curiosity that motivated their participation, and personal goal setting was a key factor in motivation. Going back to the intrinsic taxonomy section, one of the cases was they had this game with 8 darts, and if the learner was able to knock out all 8 darts, or 8 balloons with the darts, a trumpet sounded, which showed that they were the winner. And children love that. Learners love that, that positive reinforcement. All right, young people, new technologies, and learning at home. Exploring different methods of technology used to educate young people in formal and informal settings. It is important for educators and leaders to understand how young people use technology informally. Researchers argue that computer technology used informally can increase learners' agency for learning. Researchers also studied how young people navigated around the computer. The evidence shows a home with technology increases opportunities for learner-driven learning. Power of new technology has an effect in the developmental process of young people. And I found this to be hitting the nail right on the head. I remember a quick story working with a middle school student whose dad had a job in IT, and he knew computers. He knew actually how to hack into people's email addresses. And he was only like 11 or 12 years old in sixth grade. And I just thought that was the most fascinating thing, but also when I had him as a student, I realized that I had to really know what I was doing, and it really puts the pressure back on to the teachers now with this new technology to know what they're doing.